Again, it's very important that when you do a chicken tikka or anything as such, especially cooking in the intense heat, what you have here, you have to make sure that you cut your pieces quite fine. If you cut them into large chunks, then what happens is it tends to become quite thick and the center does not really cook through. So I always prefer to have them quite flat, like thin slices. So it's much easier for the flavors to penetrate. Now, very important thing is that when you actually cook a chicken tikka or when you marinate, the first thing you do is you make it into first marinade. There are always two marinades. The first part is when you add ginger garlic paste and lemon juice. Now what that does is that actually opens up the pores of the chicken, the poultry, the grain or lamb or whatever it is. It opens the pores up. And when you make the second marinade, which is basically made out of yogurt, that helps it to absorb more flavors in. First thing is you take some lemon juice and you put it on to your chicken breast. And in this, I'm also going to add ginger and garlic paste. So it's equal parts of ginger, equal parts of garlic, a little bit of oil, a little bit of water, and it's made into a very fine paste. And that is then rubbed on. Not too much salt, just a little bit of salt right now, just for it to open up and absorb more flavors in. This will normally be kept for 20 odd minutes for it to steep in into the marinade. But this is the base, this is the most important part of making a kebab. Set aside for 20 minutes. So that's been in the marinade for a while. And this we're going to add the second marinade. This is made out of yogurt, red chili powder, red chili paste, garam masala powder, some turmeric and oil. Oil is very important because that gives it a nice mouthfeel. It gives it a nice flavor to it. Mix it quite well. What you get is a beautiful piece of a chicken, and that's going to go in a tandoor eventually. That will be kept for a good 6 hours. Never try and do it for less than 6 hours because the flavors will not get through. You need to have that flavor to steep in and go into the chicken. If you don't have a tandoor at your home, which normally people don't really have, you can actually put it into a very hot oven. Take a roasting tray, heat the roasting tray, add a little bit of oil at the base and put a chicken on top of that. It goes into a very hot oven at around 180 degrees centigrade for approximately 8 minutes. And what you get is very, very nice barbecue flavored chicken breast.